An IT system shutdown has caused massive delays for hundreds of patients at WA's biggest hospital. Ambulances were turned away from Fiona Stanley for hours, and tonight the cause of the meltdown is still a mystery.
System shutdown for WA's state-of-the-art Fiona Stanley Hospital.
Fiona Stanley currently has a massive IT issue, so all our systems are down.
Patients like Gideon Digby told by phone their appointment was cancelled. He'd gone to the hospital before getting the message.
When I came in, you'd hear staff talking about as you're walking through the hospital that their computers were down. It was obviously all the computers were down because you could see some of the screens were off.
The massive IT crash happened at 10 last night. All communication down, administration computers out of action. But the crucial medical equipment was unaffected as staff worked through the night to fix the problem.
This morning we stood at the command centre at 6:30. We assessed the situation. We decided at that point to continue with the vast majority of our services.
But ambulances had to be diverted to other hospitals until about 8 a.m. Between 300 and 400 outpatients missed being seen in person or via video link.
Another day, another crisis in our hospital system.
And another reason to call for the Health Minister's resignation amid record ambulance ramping and the shock death of 7-year-old Ashwarya Aswath.
So the fact that you come in here and say, how can the public have confidence? Well, if they listen to you, member, they never would, because you are constantly undermining.
The IT system crash has again tested staff resilience at Fiona Stanley Hospital. Bed blockage code yellow alerts are becoming commonplace, and that's in a state without COVID-19.
The opposition claims there have been 185 code yellows prompted by IT issues in the past year.
We do apologise to any patients who do get disrupted today.
Patients left waiting for another appointment.
Unfortunately, I can't even log on to have a look and see when it is.
In a statement late this afternoon, the Department of Health said the IT systems were slowly returning to normal, but the cause remains unclear. Anyone with an appointment at the hospital tomorrow should be attending. That's the good news. The bad news, it seems every week there's another reason to believe our health system is locked in a crisis, even if the McGowan government won't admit it. Michael, in politics, even perception becomes reality.
It does. Gary, thank you.